starting with Power Rangers, what do you think it is about the series that made it such a global phenomenon when it came out?
I don't know. I mean, it's probably because it was action-packed martial arts and then flipping and things blowing up and giant robots, and it was a colorful show. Yeah, it was something for the kids to watch, you know. And for me, I didn't have Power Rangers when I was growing up, but I had Kung Fu movies, you know. But it's just one of those, I don't know, it's one of those shows that just hit, you know. I mean, there's a lot of things that happened on and off the camera that were a lot of fun. And really, I mean, it was fun. I had a lot of fun working on the show. I got to wear different costumes and talk to a giant floating head. There's a rubber chicken that was hidden in, I think, most of Turbo. I don't know any specifics to talk about, but I just had a good time.
You've provided the voices for some of the most iconic anime series and films. I guess maybe starting with Akira, that's a film that just continues to grow in stature, and there's constant speculation about a live-action version. What do you think it was about that film that seemed to sort of cross international boundaries and really be a big breakthrough for anime?
Well, it was one of those... for me, it was the first one that I saw that I knew it was called anime. And I'd seen it in a magazine, you know, anime or whatever, and it was just so different from anything else that, at least in the States, you know, so different from what we had then. It was all we had, like, all I knew of was, like, Popeye and Tom and Jerry and stuff like that, you know? And so to see something like that come along that had, like, this darker story, it was like a movie, it was like a film. And there's just so many bizarre things about it. Like, at the very end, when all the stuff starts going on, you're like, what is happening, you know? So it was, like, you know, outside of what you would normally think of, you know, and as far as, like, what they did in there. And so I think it was, like, there's imagery, I guess, that was done in that. And that just, you know, really sticks in the minds of people, especially back then at that time. You know, what was it, like, 89, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Trigun was the first voiceover that I did, that was, for me, it was exciting, it was different. I mean, I went from Power Rangers, you know, where I played the shy kid that didn't talk a whole lot, the background ranger, as I like to call him, and then I went and I got, you know, Vash, who's just this totally goofy character, you know, and then there's this other side to it that's a little darker and has passed, and so... I loved his character and the story and all the characters, actually, and just the way it was done, the way it looked, and just a fun show, you know?
I mean, in terms of the voice for Vash, where did that come from? And when fans meet you, I guess they always ask you to do lines. What are the most common ones people ask you to say from Trigun?
And the most common line would be, "This world is made of love and peace." The other one is, they always want me to say his full name, which I just can't do, because it was, even at the time with a script, it took me a while. But the voice, well, it was really, when I went into for the audition, they actually played me, it might have been a scratch voice, English, and then they played me the Japanese, and they were very different. And I was asked if I can do something similar to the Japanese in tone. And so I was like, sure, I'd give it a shot. And so I just kind of basically just did a higher tone as compared to what was in the scratch. And that's how I got the part. It's just a goofy character. Yeah.
Bleach is a massive series. What do you think? I mean, because there's a lot of kind of ninja-based anime, a lot of martial arts anime. But, I mean, that's one that seems to have really sort of been at the front of the zeitgeist for quite a while now.
Yeah, I mean... I don't know if it was the, I don't know, it's not really the first Shinigami kind of show, but it's one of the ones that, whatever it was with the show at the time, they did it and released it and got out there. It's like having something done in the right place in the right time, when everybody at that time was really starting to get into anime. There's like really good anime starting to pop up all over, and so people are looking for things, and you know, Bleach was one that was easy to find. You know, so I mean, it's a fun show too. I have a lot of fun with that one. It's my natural range, you know, and I feel like I can just be myself as a character. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. Haloichi goes a little different, but it's just I enjoy it. It's a long-running series. So, yeah, we're already in the 300s as far as episode-wise. So, but it's coming to an end, you know, so as far as I know.
How do you feel about that? Are you sad? I mean, do you think it's time?
I don't know. It's a little bittersweet, you know, because I've been doing it so long. It's like I'm comfortable with it, and I like being able to come in and just, I know what I'm going to do. Like, I know what the character is, so I know I can just get right into it pretty easily. And so knowing that that's going to be gone is kind of a little weird, you know? But at the same time, I'm excited for doing other things as well, you know? Not that I haven't been doing other things, but it's just nice having that steady thing that's always been there, you know? So it'd be a little bit sad that it's going to be gone.
What else is coming up for you? What have you been working on? Where are we going to see and hear you next?
I can't exactly say what I'm working on, but I am working on stuff, and I know that they're supposed to be making announcements within the next couple of months.
More anime?
There's a couple anime titles that I'm really excited to talk about, but can't. And there's a couple that aren't anime. They're more CG-based prelay animation. But I can't talk about them. I can't talk about it until they make it public, you know. There's been announcements that, you know, as far as like some of the anime that they're doing in English, but they haven't announced the cast, so I can't say anything yet.
Someone would show up in a mecha suit or with a samurai sword and just dispatch you immediately were you to mention even the merest name.
Exactly, yeah.
I guess my final question, like you say, people often ask you kind of how can they become voice actors. Do you have any advice? I mean, it's obviously a fascinating industry, but it does feel sometimes from the outside like a bit of a closed industry. You know, there's a core group of people who seem to get a lot of the leading roles in the main series.
Mm. Well, yeah, I mean, it's tough because even how I got into it, I mean, like, basically after Power Rangers, I did this live-action film with stunt guys from Power Rangers. The audio was screwed up. I had to go in and redub my character. The producer heard me, and he was also doing anime, try again. So he brought me in and asked me to audition. I auditioned for that and got it. So if the sound wasn't screwed up in that film, I never would have, you know, got into it, you know. So it was really, I just stumbled into it. But as far as that, I would say you kind of need to live where the work is. You need to be able to act, obviously, and have a decent, clear voice and be able to take direction and have really good timing because you got to match flaps as far as anime is concerned. Yeah, I don't know. I guess that would be my advice, and then get an agent and really see auditions. You know, if you can get auditions and you book a show, if you're good and you do a good job and people like you, then you might get a chance to come back in. For me, I've been very fortunate to get, you know, the roles I've gotten, and, you know, 90% of them I auditioned for, you know, and up against however many other people. So I've just been very fortunate.
There you have it, people. Get an agent, get an audition, and don't forget the talent.
That's right.
Do you have a message for fans watching this all around the world? Anything you'd like to say to them?
Thanks for the support. Because of your support, I get to come to these things and meet you guys. And so, yeah, please continue the support. Check out the stuff that I'm in. You can probably follow me on facebook.com/JohnnyYoungBosch to see. I'll be making announcements, obviously, when they let me. Other than that, take care.